Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making bacon pineapple wraps. That's a great appetizer for you. You can grill this outside on a grill, but we're going to do it in the oven, so you have that option. It's great food to serve with a grilled meal. What we're going to use is bacon. I have a pound here. I'm not going to make very many of these, just give you the idea. And then we need pineapple. What I have is one whole pineapple that I have peeled and chopped, and I've chopped it so I would have about 1-inch wedges or cubes or whatever shape they come out in. What we're going to do is take the individual slices of bacon, and I think we'll do about a dozen. That's when I've laid out 12 pieces of pineapple, and we will get 3 parts of each slice of bacon. So we'll take 4 of those out and separate them from the package and bring them to our cutting board. So it's very easy to just use some kitchen scissors and just take about 1/3 of this and cut across there, and then another 1/3 until you have about 3 equal sized pieces from that one strip, and we'll do that for the others as we need them. Then pick up a piece of pineapple and just wrap it with the bacon. You want to straighten this out if it wants to curl up on itself. And just take any side that seems convenient and start wrapping. And it should go around about once. And if it doesn't make it all the way around, that's okay. This one didn't actually. I could probably do it in a different orientation. It might work. Then we're going to use toothpicks. I have my toothpicks out here, and I have removed what I'm going to need because I don't want to be dipping back into my toothpicks that I use to serve things after I've touched bacon. So we're going to just pin this on. And what I try to do is go through the lean part. Over here, I have no choice other than to use the fat part. So we'll see if we can get that attached. Normally, it will go all the way around and I won't have that problem. But once you get it wrapped, leave the toothpicks in and then place it on a broiling pan. Now here is my broiling pan, and you can see I lined it with aluminum foil. And then on top, I covered it with a piece of aluminum foil and actually used a knife to find the slits so that any grease could drop down to the bottom. And this makes a really easy cleanup. And I've showed you this before. The first time, I think, is when we did baked bacon, which I love to do this way. And it's just such an easy and non-messy cleanup. So I'm going to continue with these and do the wrapping. And you'll see them with toothpicks in them, a dozen of them, ready to go into the oven. Here we have our 12 pieces of pineapple wrapped in bacon. The only one that has 2 toothpicks is the one I showed you, because it really is not necessary. Sometimes you need to stretch the bacon a little bit in order to make it overlap, but all of these are just really secure with one. So these are going to the oven, and I have set the oven at bake at 350. So if you want to broil, you can do that, but you have to watch them more carefully and they might burn and they might have a tendency to blacken a little bit. So I think I'd rather go with the bake, and maybe at the end, if it's taking a long time, I might turn them to broil and watch them very carefully. Our bacon pineapple wraps are out of the oven. They baked for a total of 28 minutes. Now that was because I had it on a fairly low temperature and I like them pretty crispy. I left them for 15 minutes and then I went in with tongs and turned them. So you can see it's just a matter of shifting to another side, and hopefully the bacon won't fall off if you've got it pinned on pretty well. So these are very hot and the bacon is getting pretty crispy. That's the way I like them. If you leave them much longer, they will begin to turn very dark. You can see there is some black right here that must have come off this one. But now, while they're hot, you can remove them and put them on paper toweling if you would like to soak up any of that extra fat. And then we'll just give it a couple of minutes to drain on paper toweling, and then we will transfer it to the plate. Here is our finished plate of bacon pineapple wraps. And you can see it's not very much because I was just making it for demonstration purposes. So I'm going to take a couple on my plate, and I always go for the ones that have the crispiest bacon. I made something similar to this way back, about 5 years ago, that you might have seen, maybe not, green bean bundles, and they were wrapped in bacon. So if you like French style green beans and want them wrapped in bacon and put them on the grill or do them in the oven like this, it's really a great treat to have alongside maybe a grilled hamburger or grilled chicken or a grilled steak. And of course the food doesn't have to be grilled, but it's a very good accompaniment. All right, I want to show you what this is like, which I don't know the best way to do it, but I guess I will just cut down through it and try to hold it together a little bit with this toothpick. You can see the bacon hasn't really crisped up completely, and I do like it really crisp, but it's nice. As long as it's browned up like this, it should be nice. Mmm. That pineapple is so juicy, it just bursts in your mouth. And the saltiness of the bacon is really what makes it. It's really good, I love it. I want to show you, I have an accompaniment here of some hot tea that I've made. This is lemon tea, and I'm going to put in it something that's called a honey drop. This is the way they come packaged. So you just drop one in to your hot tea and stir, and it will dissolve. It takes a little while for that to happen, but that will sweeten your tea for, I think, 20 calories. This is dried honey, and it has no additives, and it comes from the honeybee company. And I just wanted to point it out to you. You get the boxes like this of the little cubes, well, they're hexagons, I guess, that you can drop into your hot drink. It could be coffee or hot tea. They also make lozenges, throat lozenges, and they make candy. And they have some other flavors. I think they have a new flavor, but I don't know that much about it. I just ran across it, and I love it for sweetening hot tea, and I thought I would share that with you. Now back to my pineapple. You can serve this while it's just very hot, straight from the oven, or you can let it cool down a bit, and I think you'll have better luck with the bacon connecting with the pineapple if you let it cool down a little bit. Mmm, that is so good. It's surprising, really, because you have an impression of it when you look at it. It looks good. But the tasting of it is just fabulous. It's really more flavorful than fresh pineapple is, if you can imagine that. Cooking it brings out all that juice, caramelizes it, and the bacon wrapped around it adds a little bit of salt that you need. I think you'll love this.